I don't really think it's hit me yet, and I don't know when it's gonna hit me. I mean, I have my moments where I'm like I was driving the car to visit my girlfriend the other day, and I just started breakdown crying. I'm like, what are you doing? But like, it's just like the dream is coming true.
Seems like your draft stock has been on the rise ever since your pro day. I know you had an ankle injury, cost you some of your senior season, but I recently saw you dunking a ball on your Twitter. I know you got the hops, and those workouts went so well, that had to give you some peace of mind.
I've never really thought of myself as an underdog until I hurt my ankle. And then I tried to avoid what people were talking about and everything, but I saw things like, oh, he hurt his ankle, that's gonna hurt his stock and whatnot. And I just, that kind of always kept that in the back of my head during the whole recovery process and everything. So I was really excited to show off my athleticism.
What has the last couple weeks been like for you? I know you've been traveling, going to visit some teams, and you've had like 15 teams come visit you too.
I mean, I've been everywhere from the East Coast to the Midwest. It's been workouts with all these teams and just getting to learn a lot of knowledge from all kinds of different NFL coaches. It's been overwhelming at times. It's been very busy, but I'm living the dream.
At this point, it seems like you're a lock to be picked in the top 40. I know the Vikings are sitting there end of the first round. If they were to pick you, would that be the ultimate dream?
I mean, any team that picks me, ultimate dream, but something special. I mean, I grew up and my room was purple and gold, so I think that says enough. I'd be able to be with my mom every day and be able to be with my family, and it'd be a dream come true for sure.
If you think back to your days at Chanhassen, did you think you'd be sitting here someday? Did you have that confidence in yourself back then?
Yeah, you may think I'm crazy, but this has always been the plan, and it's bittersweet right now because it's always me and my dad's plan, and he passed away, but it's crazy how it's all coming full circle, but we always thought you just got to take one thing at a time.
You mentioned your dad. How tough was that for you, and how were you able to push through that and get to the point where you are now?
It's brutal, and it's still brutal. I'm not gonna lie to you, especially right now. I mean, and the thing is, he was my best friend, and throughout this whole, it wasn't just my dream, it was our dream, and throughout this whole football, I mean, I remember getting recruited by Coach Kill, going to Nick Saban's office, going to Florida State, going to Arkansas, and just being like two little kids after we went with visit these coaches freaking out. And I mean, he had Google Alerts set up. So whenever in Arkansas there was ever an article read about me, he'd get a text and he'd read it. So I mean, right now with all these good things and exciting things happening with the NFL, it's really bittersweet, you know, just wondering what if he was here and everything.
Well, I know he'd be very proud of you.
Thank you.
That's for sure. I see a lot of draft talk saying you're the best center in this class, but other teams maybe are looking at you to play guard. Do you have a preference? Do you care where you end up playing?
I just love playing football. I just like getting out there and get after guys. I think it's kind of been a 50-50 shot of teams seen at both positions, and I think that helps me overall because I can play multiple positions. So we'll see. Wherever they want me to play, I'll play.